they have a free hand, and were there ever cases where a move or moves that he wanted to make were vetoed by upper management?
There was never a case where moves that Ray wanted to make was vetoed by upper management, and never did upper management or ownership tell Ray what players to go after, and Ray will tell you the same thing. Ray had complete autonomy. We have a very good ownership group here. We're very lucky, and he was given free rein.
Did you guys have a specific time frame you need to do this? Do you feel it's important to have a GM before the draft?
I have a specific. We have a specific time frame. We want to do it as quickly as possible to have the GM come in and do the evaluation process as fast as we can. We're not going to rush it because of the draft. We think that we have, with Jason Botterill and with our scouting staff and Tom Fitzgerald, we have a group in place that can take care of us for the draft.
You mentioned changes coming. At this point, which players on the roster would you say are untouchable in this organization right now?
I'm not going to talk at all about what players or individual moves. We're going to leave that to the new general manager when they come in, and we'll make those evaluations as we move forward. Right now, what we're doing is we're making a change at the top of the hockey department, and we're changing the general manager.
Dave, you said the search is already underway for a new GM. When you fire a guy like Ray, who's been around for so long and respected as he is, you guys, do you have anybody in mind? In other words, before you let somebody go, you must have an idea that you are going to be able to replace him with somebody.
I mean, we have a, first of all, Ray Shero is a great guy. I said that in the remarks earlier. And we all have relationships with him. And he's done some really good things here. Unfortunately, we haven't been able to get to the level that we want to get to and that ownership wants us to get to. So we think bringing someone in can help make that happen. What was the second part of your question?
Well, no, just that when you don't let somebody go in a lot of instances, in a lot of lines of work, unless you're pretty sure you have somebody that you can bring
in. We don't have anyone in particular in mind. We have a large group of people in mind, and we think that we'll get more people interested now that we've announced that we have an opening. But we think we'll have a lot of interest, but we have no one in particular that we're looking at, other than Jason Botterill, who's a candidate that you all know.
David, in terms of hockey ops, the philosophical approach with the NHL, maybe kind of the rule changes or things have changed since 2005 in terms of hockey, do you think there's a whole different philosophy or a whole different kind of change of direction in kind of the style of play you want out of your team and your personnel?
I'm going to leave that up to Mary Lemieux and Ron Burkle and the general manager, but I don't think that the rule changes necessarily have changed the way we want to play. I think we want to have a team that's hard to play against. We want to have a fast team. We want to have a tough team. We want to have a team with character. That hasn't changed.
David, was there any one specific aspect of Ray's job, whether it was drafting, salary cap management, talent evaluation, that maybe weighed heavier into this decision than others?
No, there wasn't one specific thing. This is just over time not getting to the level that we think we need to get to.
David, right here, I have two. One, just to be 100% clear here, you have not fired Dan Bylsma.
That's correct. We have not fired Dan Bylsma.
Is there an element of weirdness to that? And in addition to not just on your end, but also on those coaches' ends, because they could, in theory, be looking for other jobs that are available right now.
I don't think there's an element of weirdness. I think what we're trying to do is we're trying to do it systematically. And what we wanted to do was first address the situation at the top, and the leader of the organization is the general manager. Once that's done, then we want to evaluate whether or not. And another thing, Dejan, this is not as I said before, it's not a complete rebuild. This is a team that has had a level of success. What we're trying to do is get from good to great. We're in the top quartile of the league in everything we do. A lot of teams would like to be where we are. However, we do have high expectations, and we want to get to it. So we don't need to just come in and clean complete house right away. We think we can do this systematically, and we can make adjustments, and we can get to where we need to get.
David, will the new GM be hired with any input from the ownership on any determinations you made internally about the coach? Will there be any expectations of him? Will your feelings
be
any discussions made among the ownership about Dan Bylsma, and will those be passed on to the new GM?
No, I think that the new GM is going to have, along with ownership, they're going to evaluate the situation and make a determination as it regards to Dan Bosman and the coaching staff, and as it relates to the person we hire, it has no relation whatsoever.
Dan's still under contract. If another team would show interest in him, is he free to entertain that, or is he on hold until it's decided here?
Well, he's under contract, and another team's not allowed to entertain thoughts. But I have complete confidence that if Dan is indeed not the coach here, that he'll be quickly picked up somewhere else. He's a great coach.
Thanks, David.
Thank you.